Hi, in this video I will show you how to make a total rebuild of your coffee grinder for Saeco or Jura. So if you have a machine Saeco or Jura with this type of coffee grinder, you can rebuild it, and I will show you how to disassemble, clean and assemble the whole machine and the whole coffee grinder. So first we remove the blades. Here in the center you have a screw. It's not normal thread, it's a reverse thread. So when you normal you tighten the screw, you untighten here. So here it is. We remove the parts. You can see here. So now we remove the black plastic. As you can see. Here, I will show you what is the most common problem. This plastic covered the mechanic of the coffee grinder. So, as you can see here, is a hole, and the coffee start go inside the mechanism that transfer power from the motor to the blades of the coffee grinder. So low this planetary gears inside lower the RPM of the motor and give power to the blades. So what happened again, you have a coffee inside and the coffee grinder blocked. If your coffee grinder, one of the possibilities is to block and not turn, then you have to remove this plastic here and clean and assemble the motor again. But if the motor turn, that means some of these gears here are broken, and you have to find spare parts of this. So first, how to remove the mechanism inside. So as you can see here, you have a metal balls. So we need to remove the metal balls. So I use a flat screwdriver. It's around 3 millimeters thickness. So I go here and very carefully, you can see the balls start to go out, and you have to watch for the balls. You can maybe lost one or two, but more is not good. So as you can see here, I damaged the plastic. So you don't want to damage all the way the plastic, so I move the next ball on the same place where was the first ball that I remove. So I go here. Yeah, I have spares, but be careful. And I just will do it here. You can see. Remove the next one, and when you remove some of the balls, it will loosen and you can remove all of them. Every time it's easier to remove. Again. You can see it's much easier when you remove 4 or 5, and because there is coffee and it's tight, but it start to loosen. Now it's it's almost okay. I think it's no, it needs more of the bolts removed. Here now you can see it's loosened enough and I can go and remove off all of the bolts. So now we remove the bolts and these bolts and the bolts that are on the bottom of the blade are the same size, so it doesn't matter if this bolt was here or here on the blade, they are the same size. So as you can see here, now we can go inside the mechanics. You can see here I damage a little bit of the plastic, but it's only on one place. I can, but I'm going to do it after I put the bolts, metal bolts back. So again you have to clean this. And this is, it's not easy because it's a lot of coffee. You can see these are, oops, just for a second here, I want to, okay. See, this is what it's happening. This gear here, the some of the gears stop turning and this destroy this gear. This is how it has to look, you can see. But now it's damaged. And if you have this problem, the motor will turn, but not the mechanic and the blades will not turn, only the motor. So you will need spare parts for the mechanism. I will show you how to remove, if you want to, if all of your gears are okay. You can see you have these pieces here, don't lose it. You remove, you can see this is the gear. You have three, you can see, you push and you have the pin and the gear is out. So the gear, let me show you, is different from this side and this side, but it doesn't matter how you push, you install the gear. So here you remove this and you have these smaller gears. Again, they don't matter how you put the gears. But of course, we will replace this. So here you have to clean. You have two screws here on the bottom. I use a flat screwdriver, but it's Phillips. Let me show you. We have the motor and the two screws, and here you just have to clean all of this for assembling the. So first what we going to do is to test the motor. So first, if you have a movement here between the aluminum part and the metal part in these three places, you can use flat screwdriver here and here, and tap with the hammer very gently, not so much, if you have a movement here. I don't have a movement, you can see it's okay, but if you have a big movement, you can see here and here, you tap with the hammer and make it good. So first, let me remove these pieces here. Now I will put the carbon brushes. Again, you cannot buy these brushes from anywhere. It's 4x6, and I make them from bigger brushes here. Spring and this piece here. So you can see here, the spring is not on the right place, like this. It's maybe needs to be more flat. No. Like this. Let's try again. Yes, now it's okay. No. There are two types, new, old. Let me show you. Maybe this is the right. You can see one is with the hole. This doesn't have hole. I don't know. Let me try this. Yeah, this one is better. Now, the next one. Here, the spring. And now I know I need this piece with the hole. And something else, if you need to, some of the motors have this electronics here and on the metal, you can remove it. It's not super important if you have this. If you can put it back, okay, but it's not a problem. Now we have the motor, and I will again I will test the motor if it's okay, so I can continue to assemble. Okay. The motor works perfectly, doesn't have a problem. So we start to assemble the gearbox here. We need lubricant, it doesn't matter, it's for cars, but you don't have contact between these parts and the coffee, so you can use normal lubricant. So we put this, we have two bolts here. Again, I use flat screwdriver, but it's Phillips. now it's okay. Yes, when you have the right tool, everything is okay. So the next screw, bolt, again, like this, takes some small amount of lubricant, not too much. Okay, we have a little bit of movement, but it's okay. So we need to put lubricant on the two rows of teeth, that it's from the bottom, one, two. The third one, it doesn't work, it doesn't play with the mechanism. So I put some lubricant like this, not too much, only to cover the teeth on the mechanism. You don't need so much, because I'm going to put some also on the gears. Okay, I think we are okay. So now we have the smaller gear. You clean as much as you can. Put some here. Small gears, it doesn't matter how you put them, maybe just a little bit here. Now here, the next one. And the third one. Now, this one, you can see from the one side, you have like a spacers on the plastic, from the other side is flat. So these spacers are with the wheels. You push and you have the mechanism complete. Okay, we have the one. Now the second one, you can see again we have three wheels, gears. You put lubricant and again doesn't matter how you put the gears, you can see the hole, push. And it's flat. The next one, maybe too much. Okay, and the third. This is the easy part. The most difficult part is to put back the steel balls on the place. Okay, so now we need to put this here. This one here, maybe need some. Now I put small amount of lubricant, just a little bit, so it's easy for the metal balls to move. And here, this one is clean, as you can see. So now we put this like this, and we start to put the bolts back. It's easy when it's almost empty. But with every metal ball it's more difficult and more difficult. Don't lose it, because for you maybe it's a problem. I have, you can see, a lot of spares, so I don't worry. Again, I put the bolts from this hole that I make when I start to remove the See how it's click, but it's going to be much, much more difficult when we are on the last 7 or 8 bolts. It's not a problem now, it's a hole, but it's not a problem for the mechanics. It starts to getting really... I can move it back here if I want. See, this one is dirty. After a few more, it starts to hurt my finger, so I can put gloves. It's old glove, but it's better with glove, not with my hand. Come on. And because I think here the hole is a little bit bigger, I will not need the screwdriver to put everything back. I will show you. If you don't have so big hole here, you need to push like this, so with one hand, let me show you, with one hand like this, so you can see, you go with the screwdriver here into a little bit place and push. If you don't have such a big hole, but this one is okay. So now we are okay. What I'm going to do with pliers, I will make him like this, and I will turn the motor. So we have enough metal balls. It's not a problem here. The ball will not go out because we have this on the top. So now we have to assemble everything else. We put this, we have this here, And I have a few more videos how to replace. I have a small amount of water here. It's not good. And every time I put this black plastic first, but I can do it and feel how everything else is go back here. But for you it's easy, this plastic to put the last. I will show you. You put this black rubbers here, and now this. And if you don't have the black plastic here, it's easy. You can see these pieces that it's go here, so you can see. And now it's on the right place. We need springs here on the hole in the see, one of the holes are bigger. Look, these are small holes, these are big. Big, small. So the small goes on the plastic. Or it's not going to work because you cannot push these springs on the right place. Two, three. You need three bolts like this. You need the new blade. Okay. You need where it is, this spacer here. It's a little bit dirty, but this plastic, there is a special way. You can see here. Oh, let me see. It has to go like this. And when you don't have the black plastic outside, it's easy for you to find the three holes for the metal balls. This here, you can see how it has to be. And now this one, I recommend you, so when you tighten this, it's reverse thread. So again, and when you start, you turn a little bit back. Listen, just listen. Oh, this doesn't want to click, but you turn so it can find the thread and tie. Just for a second here, you hear the click, and now I turn. You can see, however, you don't have to have space here. You can see how everything is go together. And don't use too much force to tighten this here, this screw here, because here where the screw goes is plastic. If you break the plastic, you have a problem, you have to replace the whole thing. So be careful with tighten this screw. It's normal. So now we have to put this black piece. I just only want to show you after how to clean this. You have three plastic locks here with the flat screw driver. You click one, two, three. This is good to clean here. And also don't lose You can see here there is a spring and the metal ball goes in this hole here, but you have to remove it to clean this black plastic from everywhere. And when you're ready, you push the spring, the ball, and just all of this to click. Now you have this piece here. This one lock is bigger. You find the bigger one. Okay. Now we put the new blade here. You have two locks here. You can see here the light. See this and this. Now most of the grinders have a red and blue color here and here, and you have a little triangle here and here. So what happened is triangle. Here you have this is red, as you can see here on the ring. It has to be a blue, so we start from here, blue, and go to red. And from here you can adjust your coffee grinder how to grind the coffee. But now we clean and replace what was broken with the mechanics here. We replace everything on the top. You see how to remove the holder for the brushes and clean and everything. This is 100% rebuilt coffee grinder, and you can use it for Saeco, and you can use it for Jura. You can see this piece here. Again, I have another video. You can see the difference is only this plastic. This is from Jura and this is from Saeco. So you can see if I can find from Jura a good motor with the mechanics, I need to remove only this piece here and put Saeco, and I can use on Saeco or the other way around. So you have options. This is for now. Bye.